In this video, we will look at how to get started with ThreatSync. First, we will want to know what is ThreatSync. Then, of course, where can I activate it? And look at the data shown to us and actions we can take. So what is ThreatSync? Well, ThreatSync is a cloud platform service that can analyze and correlate event data from multiple sources, which provides a huge advantage to identify malicious behavior and to present it all in a simple UI to perform resolution actions. ThreatSync is included as a WatchGuard Unified Security feature with Firebox Total Security Suite, Access Point USP Wi-Fi Management, WatchGuard EDR, EPDR, and Advanced EPDR. Okay, so we know a little bit more now, but where do we activate ThreatSync now? Well, for that we need to log into WatchGuard Cloud, so let us do that. After the login, we found ourselves in the WatchGuard Cloud dashboard. Generally, you can find ThreatSync under Monitor and Configure, but since we have not activated ThreatSync yet, we also have the options to do this within the dashboard. Where? Just a scroll down away. So let us activate it. Once it has completed, we find ourselves in Device Settings, which as mentioned before is found under Configure. Here we see that endpoints and devices are unable to send incident data and receive actions. Since we have nothing to change here, we can go to see some threats. For this, we go to Monitor and then Threats. Here we see the summary with information for pending incidents and incident status, along with the incident timeline below. At the moment, we don't see anything. Not because we might have the wrong filter in use, which by the way can be changed according to our needs. No, we need to be a little bit patient for the incidents to happen. You see, here they start to show up. This quick overview now shows us that we have new incidents, high, medium, and low. There is the option to click on each of the circles or dots in the timeline, which leads us to the incidents area but in a filtered view. Yet for now we want to just go there to see these in a list with some more information. So we have several incidents listed for access points, endpoints, and fireboxes. How do I recognize this? Easy, just check out the icons. Let us take a closer look at the listed incident and click somewhere in the field. Here we have some more details and also a recommendation or advice what perhaps to do, which in this case could be to isolate the endpoint. Let us do that and click on Isolate Device here or use the icon below. Now this process takes a moment to happen as this is happening live. And once it has succeeded, we can see this too. On the endpoint, the user will see this kind of information. So now it would be time to investigate more, and if the endpoint is considered being safe again, we can click on the stop icon to de-isolate the endpoint. Again, this change is not instant, yet skipped it to not bore you. Since this incident has been worked on, we can archive it and return to the incident list. Now let us have a look at the Firebox incident. Next to automatic response, we can see that the connection was already blocked by the Firebox, and in the network connection details below, we can see that the host was trying to download something from this external IP address using the protocol HTTPS. We could consider at this point to possibly block this IP address on all eligible Fireboxes. Let us do this and click on the icon with a flash and then into the shown field. Again, this process will also take a moment to complete, but once that happens, we can see the result accordingly. So now at this point, if a host tries to connect to this IP address, the connection will be blocked, and we can for example see this in the traffic monitor of Firebox System Manager. Just think about it. We've just saved resources on all eligible Fireboxes in a way to let them know to block this IP address right away, and no need to run through any further Firebox security services. So let us head back to the incident list again. I can hear you already say, do I honestly have to do this manually for every single incident? No, for this we can use automation policies, which we can find under Configure and then ThreatSync. With a click on Add Automation Policy, we can start to give the policy a name, choose the policy type, the condition for risk range, incident type, and device type. Then we need to decide what action should be performed and select the according action checkboxes. To save a little time, here's an example of two policies and their status, so if enabled or not. You can, of course, generate default policies to start with these two. The policy order is from top to bottom, so incidents that match a policy will not be verified to other policies further down the list. It is possible to reorder the policies with these handles. To enable or disable a policy, just use the slider on the far right. Once all is set, the changes just need to be deployed. One big advice about automation policies. Please, take your time to make yourself familiar with the types of incidents and not try to automate remediation on all incidents, as you might see unwanted results based on your configured policies. So, start simple and build from there. Under IPs blocked by ThreatSync, you have a great overview of all blocked IP addresses and the option to select the according checkboxes to unblock these in one step. A very similar function is available for endpoints under Monitor, Threats, then Endpoints. This is a centralized list of endpoints and allows you to review and perform actions like isolate device and stop isolating either for one or more endpoints at once. Here are some key takeaways. ThreatSync provides a quick view of threats across multiple platforms. Many incidents have already been taken care of by the service, yet critical threats most possibly need additional remediation. Use automation policies to help you automate incident remediation. ThreatSync is included as a WatchGuard Unified Security feature with Firebox Total Security Suite, Access Point USP Wi-Fi Management, WatchGuard EDR, EPDR, and advanced EPDR. More details can of course be found in the WatchGuard Help Center, using technical search, but also watch the useful videos available around ThreatSync.